Hey guys, this is Primeval. Welcome to part 7 of my playthrough of Deity Challenge number 12 from the Civ Fanatics forums. So like I was saying before, the AI plays a totally different game than you do on Deity. They basically have no happiness limit. So we're doing pretty well here with 8 happiness, but everyone else has 20 plus happiness, peaking over at 53 excess happiness. Okay, so we should get to work on the National College. It might actually be better if we use the Great Engineer on the National College, because as much as I do like the idea of getting some good gold per turn going, we really do need the extra science to get us to crossbows sooner. So plus 3 and plus 50%, that'll get us another 10 science. That's a 25% increase, and that'll shave a good 4 or 5 turns off of reduction. 4 or 5 turns off of our journey to crossbows. So I think I will have to go and use the Great Engineer on the National College here, and we'll have to give up our dreams of getting Machu Picchu. That also means that we don't want to capture Truro just yet, in case the library of Truro got destroyed when the persons capture it, or if our overeager Pictish warrior destroys it as we capture Truro. So let's go and run this guy away. We'll move back one and get this Pictish warrior into the mix. Over here. And we'll just go and capture Truro next turn after we build the National College. Meanwhile, we'll get our composites set up for their siege of the Persian capital. And we'll go and scout Barcelona. They do have a few units now, 3 composites and a spearman, and they're at 28 strength. Alright, on to turn 101. Our unit's healing up, and we can go and grab some more experience on these composite bows here, and finish off this archer and this great general. So now we're pumping 40 science per turn. There was still the library in Truro, it did survive, so that's definitely nice. Let's see. Will any of our archers be able to make it into range to attack that archer? It doesn't look like that will be the case. Okay, so let's see if the Greeks will take peace. It's no time for negotiation, and a lot of that has to do with probably their military strength is quite a bit higher than ours. But one thing to note is that Persia now has a weaker army than us, and so it's definitely time for us to move on their capital. Choosing production, we finished our National College. Let's grab a catapult. And let's start moving our composites in on the Persians. Okay, everything's looking good. We are now 12 turns from machinery, so grabbing that National College really did speed things up. And really, the National College was much more important for us than Machu Picchu. Maybe one of our neighbors will build Machu Picchu, and we can steal it from them. Okay, can fortify and heal there. Dublin has grown. Truro should be on production focus. And I guess we will keep this composite bow around to defend Madrid. Looks like Harold could be in a position to attack Korea. Let's see, other players declare war on Harold. Nope. What about Harold? Four horses. Yeah, I could part with four horses. And so that'll help keep Korea in check as well. Harold has also declared war on Persia, and so I don't want them to capture any Persian cities, since I want Persia to act as a buffer between me and Harold. I want to keep the number of armies we're fighting, the number of civs we're fighting, to a minimum. Just fight one civ at a time, maybe two civs at a time if necessary. And so if we open up another front with Harold, then we could end up fighting Isabella, the Greeks, and Harold all at the same time. So here, I think we're going to want to build our monument again. So I think all culture-generating buildings are automatically destroyed when a city is captured by the enemy. So that's why I sold the monument last time around, just to get a little extra gold. We're also going to want to get ourselves a worker. We only have the one worker right now, and it's over by Madrid. We will capture some workers once we wander into Persia's territory, but we lost two workers to them earlier, so I think... Well, how long will Truro take to train a worker? 18 turns. Shoukyu at the queue. 5 turns for a worker here. Let's just go and buy a worker here. 310, though. That money would be so much better spent elsewhere. I would like to finish that trade route. I would like to repair those tiles. Let's take a look at our luxury resource list. Let's go buy that worker. Okay. So we're moving in on the Persian capital here. I think they built the Hanging Gardens several turns ago. They do have the Hanging Gardens, so that'll be nice, something to claim for ourselves. Yep, there's the Hanging Gardens right there. Caesar wants to buy our truffles. I would gladly accept. Okay, our influence with Quebec City has fallen. That's fine. Milan wants us to collect or connect copper, and they're accepting extra gold. Babylon has denounced Denmark. our friendship with Rome has expired, but if we do want to maintain good relations with both Babylon and Rome, we don't need to rush into declaring friendship there. And here's a worker, a Danish worker, so it's actually just in the way. Let's get ourselves forward. Okay, bombard, nothing, advance one tile, and bombard. Okay, based on the positioning of Isabella's units, it's possible she's gearing up for war. Our peace treaty did expire quite a while ago. Let's go and repair our trade network. Okay, so that swordman captured that Danish worker for us so that we can go and capture the Persian worker for ourselves. We'll get ready to do that. We'll take it. So this catapult looks like he's in trouble. I might want to run that catapult away. We finished up the trading post. And here, the fastest way back to our borders is to the south, but there's also some good scouting to be done to the north. Huh. Alright, so this catapult might just be dead. I guess that happens sometimes. And next turn, we'll move in on the Persian capital. Well, I guess we should move in now since there are a bunch of units behind who also need to move to the front lines. Okay. On to the next turn. There goes our catapult. Harold has made peace with Darius, but they did capture Susa here, which does mean we'll be sharing a border with Harold when we capture the Persian capital. So that's a catapult. We could grab a market or a watermill. Let's grab ourselves another worker. Although we just captured a worker, we could go for the watermill to help our capital grow, get our science rolling, or we could grab a granary, which would get us an additional 6 gold. And that'll add up a little faster than the watermill. So let's go and grab the market here. Repairing the road now. can withdraw this composite and move in with everyone else. Okay, so here we'll go and drop our composite into Madrid and hide our Pictish warrior in this forest. We can go and build a camp here, or repair. That's a road. I don't know if we need to be paying the upkeep on that road. Let's get over here and perhaps remove that road, or maybe have our worker captured by Spain. So Cardiff has grown. Yep, those tiles look good. Although I think I actually do want to grow Cardiff a little more here, so let's grab the food tile, and if we can grow Dublin as well, that wouldn't be bad. Okay, Pictish warrior complete. We could go finish that monument. I think we had already put a bunch of turns into it. No, we hadn't. So instead, let's go and grab ourselves another Pictish warrior. Okay, let's see what the Persians do here. They're offering peace. Losing grasp on Tyr. We're getting some happiness from them. Turo has grown. That looks fine as well. Here we can take the rough terrain and fortify there. Go and swap out. Okay, so we have another Pictish warrior ready. Fortify and remove this road. Okay, so looks like the Danish are having a good time with their war against the Koreans. And we're having a good time with our war against the Persians. Their military might is still quite low. Okay, so an AI had just entered the Renaissance. That was Korea, and so we got ourselves a spy. We can probably go and drop the spy into, well, the largest city we actually know of is Persia. Let's see if we can go and trade embassies with Korea. Alright, 25 gold is a steal as far as being able to drop our spy into the tech leader's capital. So Korea's right there. There was all this rough terrain in the way, so we couldn't actually see it. Let's finish that trade route and get our Pictish warrior into the action. So here we can pillage. Pull back. We got ourselves another great person, that's our great general, that's definitely nice. So let's swap positions here. You can pillage that tile. And we'll go and drop down over there. So Korea no longer wants to pay us full price for salt. What sort of deal will they offer us? 208 in open borders. 208. So that's actually 209. Okay, we lost a Pictish warrior there. City attack, pikeman attack, and a swordsman attack, so that was good. It protected all of our comps, I suppose, from damage. Go and repair that tile so we can earn a little gold and get our hit points back. The whole repairing tiles is kind of silly. You shouldn't be able to repair your opponent's tiles, or you should be allowed to pillage your own tiles. One of those, I think, would make it a little more fair and sensible. Okay, so there's another composite bow. Let's go and grab ourselves. A granary would help with growth. We definitely do want to get these cities a little larger. We don't have the happiness right now, but as our religion spreads, and we do have decent pressure, we should be getting more happiness off of ceremonial burial. And perhaps this particular composite bow might want to go up towards Madrid. Nah, I think it'll be okay. Although we do have more than enough units to deal with Persia. However, once we go and turn towards Alex or Harold, likely Alex since we're already at war and he's already very hostile with us, we will need a stronger army. However, by that time, we should have machinery. So, the plan here is conquer Persia within 3 turns. On the 4th turn, we'll have machinery, and we can upgrade as many composites to crossbows as we can afford. And then we'll go and attack the Greeks. Okay, the Koreans have reclaimed Busan from the Danish. We're about to repair a trade route, and we'll just leave the Great General there for now. Actually, let's actually start building a second army over by Madrid, just because that is, we will at some point have to deal with the Spanish, and we have enough units here, especially once we upgrade to crossbowmen. So we lost another Pictish warrior there. That's too bad, although it did take two units to take it down. Here we got a promotion. Let's grab rough terrain, since the road to the Greek lands seems to be full of rough terrain. Ragusa has a good five units to defend themselves, so I'm liking the looks of that. Let's go and pillage some tiles here. Resource-wise, we still have truffles. Uh, 15 damage, that is not going to be enough to take the city, I don't believe. I think there used to be a time where you could see the hit points that the city actually had, but I'm not really sure how to get that, and we did accidentally go and attack the city anyways, unsuccessfully. At least we have a second melee unit in range. And are Alex and Korea at war? Alexander is at war with us. Friends with Korea. Okay, so they have open borders. That's what's happening there. Sure, we can build a camp. Although, view city. If we do build a camp there, we'll lose a faith per turn. And since we're not actually interested in the extra hammer at the moment, let's cancel that. Okay, next turn. We're probably going to lose another Pictish warrior here. Yes, we did. But we should be able to capture the city any moment now. We finished that trade route after repairing that tile. There's nothing else we can pillage here except for this farm. Alright, let's view the city. We've got the Hanging Gardens, granary, library, and watermill. Not bad. Here's a puppet. We are very unhappy now, however. If we go commerce, we are pumping 17 gold per turn. So another 2 gold out of commerce, that's not that helpful. Patronage, we do have one city-state ally, and so that'll help our gold go a little farther. And so patronage is an option. Honor is also possible, since we are going for a military victory here. And if we get a couple steps in here, and given how slowly it's going to take us to get to the Renaissance, we might actually end up sinking a few policies into honor here. Okay. The first step is pretty useless, but the subsequent steps will be applicable when we go total war, and we have been, by and large, doing nothing but war. So let's go and open up honor here. Okay, our next policy is in 31 turns. Persia lost its capital, trade route, Bucharest. It's way over there. We lost a Pictish warrior. We can start construction on a Colosseum, a circus. Okay, where can we get some more happiness? If we do go and throw some gold at Genoa, let's see, does anyone want anything special? Manila will get us more money, but it's way off over there by Rome. So let's go and throw some money at Genoa. Although that didn't help us as much as I thought it would. I guess we already had the furs. So now we have double furs. And we were already receiving the happiness from being friends with them. Okay, so that wasn't the best deal. Is there another city-state? Jerusalem has wine. We've traded our wine away. Jerusalem wants us to grab silver and get a great scientist. Now, giving Tyr a little money would definitely help us. They want this barbarian encampment cleared, so let's just give them the smallest amount of money first to get us up to friends so we're not facing the combat penalty and the production penalty, and that'll give us time to get our happiness buildings online. Let's go and deal some damage here. Okay, so Cardiff, that'll be part of our Madrid North Army. And here, I guess we can just go and repair that mine. Let's get that salt online. And we're good. Actually, taking the Persian capital put us into second place. Negotiate peace. Cities. They only have the one city. So if we did go and make peace with them, negotiate peace, then we wouldn't get the huge diplomatic penalty for eliminating a civ. But they're not willing to give us a very sweet peace deal right now, so we'll wait. So the Babylonians just built the Mausoleum of Halicarnassus. Persia is retreating their units to Parsegrad. Seoul is plotting against Nebuchadnezzar. We'll go and share intrigue to get a little more positive diplomatic favor with them. Let's go and grab the rough terrain here and fortify until healed. We are continually. Ooh, excellent. We've got either logistics or range or march. Let's get logistics here since that'll let us earn experience even faster. So here. these guys will start sending... we'll send 2 units north to take care of that barbarian camp. Okay, so we've repaired that camp. And our skilled archer can finally return home and receive all of the upgrades he deserves. Spare truffles can be sold. We can sell 4 horses. So if we throw horses into the deal, how about 6? Alright, 5 gold per turn. So we have a little more money for upgrades now, and we should be able to upgrade next turn. Let's go and repair that mine. And since we do have the upgrade coming, we may as well stay in our borders for a little longer. Okay, so I think that's where we'll stop part 7, and I'll see you in part 8.